6.
Yeah, well, I'm just trying to go do something, really. Oh, my goodness. What?
Hey, what you doing there, boy?
Oh, I was trying to record a podcast,
No, back away. Oh, back away, boy. You gotta have the know-how to do this.
I thought I didn't know. I was trying to be like you. I was trying to make a podcast, sir.
Oh, come on. Use your head, boy. Not like that. Talk to the people. Tell them something.
Well, if you come to Anchor, maybe you will learn how to podcast the right way.
No, not like that.
Well, I don't know.
Here's how you tell them.
Yeah.
You go to anchor.fm. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your own podcast right from your phone or your computer.
It's that easy?
You ask a silly question, you get a silly answer. Of course it is, there, boy. What you doing there?
Well, I just thought I'd be like you and I could maybe podcast or something.
No. That'll never work. You can't be like me.
Well,
I already have the best podcast in the land.
In the whole land?
The entire land, boy. Everybody knows it.
I've heard that you do have the greatest podcast. Is it on the What's the Play family?
Of course it is there, boy. Another silly question with another silly answer.
Well, so how do I get started?
Well, you download the free Anchor app, and you go to anchor.fm to get started. All right, boy?
All right.
I don't want to tell you again.
You told me.
I got other places to go, other places to see. Oh, boy. You can't tie a pumpkin to a tree that way. Get over here.
What'sTheplay.net. The answer to all of your questions right now in this time of crisis, this time of uncertainty. The only true thing in this world is whatstheplay.net. You go to whatstheplay.net and you type in your question, and one of our staff members will help you out, whether it's to get your mom to the doctors, whether it's to get your EBT, whether it's to get your stimulus check, it doesn't matter. Or maybe it's whether to deal with all the uncertainness that comes with this. So, you know, maybe your relationship is not going the right way. It doesn't matter. Go to whatstheplay.net and all of your problems will be a lot easier, I promise you. A lot easier. So remember, today, tomorrow, the next day, in these times of uncertainty, we are praying for each and every one of you, making sure that each and every one of you are healthy. But the only way we can do that is working together. Working together as a community. So remember, go to whatstheplay.net, and together we will solve all of life's issues that they're throwing at us. Remember, whatstheplay.net.
Welcome to the Who Cares podcast, a podcast that enters your soul, with your host, Stephen Moraga.
All right, we're live here on the Who Cares podcast. It's me, Stephen with a PH, live here on the Who Cares podcast.
Yes!
Yes!
COVID-19. Is that COVID-19? So, it's been a long time.
And it's starting me, Stephen, with a PH.
I'm here.
And the Southern Belle. Ding, 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 ding.
Southern Montebello.
Southern Montebello, Southern Downey.
Southern Whittier, anywhere you want to call it, San Gabriel Valleys.
Valleys.
So, wow, it seems like it's been forever.
I mean, the whole world seems like
I didn't know
forever.
If you were dead or if...
Well, you could have listened to the podcast.
And
to everybody out there, these are the last 5 episodes. This is number 4.
I can't believe it.
It's coming to an end.
Oh, it's like one of those shows.
Remember, you know?
Yeah.
Like those shows?
Like Seinfeld coming to an end, or Friends, or any of those, you know.
Yeah.
Am I really, like, revealing nobody knows those shows?
No, they watch them on Netflix.
You know, everybody loves the 80s and 90s. Yeah. So
it's kind of like that.
Yeah, it's like the end of an era.
It is the end of an era, but it's the beginning of a new era.
Wow.
Era.
Yeah.
But
so,
in the new era, you will be a part of it.
Oh, really? I get to? Oh, thank you.
You're going to have your own show.
And you know what? I have exciting news.
Oh, shit. Here it comes already.
It's 20 years in the making.
Okay.
But I will finally have a college degree.
Let's, ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause. Oh, my goodness.
So by the next show that you start, I will be a college student.
Yeah. Okay, wait. One more time. You're going to what?
I will be a college grad.
And you picked the COVID time.
I know, right? I know. Like a month ago, I got the news saying, hey guys, proud of you. We're sorry to tell you, but we're not going to have, you know, a graduation ceremony. There's not going to be any cap and gown walking.
They did
to
get not.
Yeah. And I was like, of course, that's fine. I'm like, I didn't really want to be there anyways, but I was like, of course that would happen.
Yeah.
When, after 20 years.
Of going to school. You could have had 4 doctorates.
You know what? I totally could have. And what's even more crazy is that, like, I used to want to be a doctor, and I thought, what? 8 years plus 2 years of residency? No way, man. That's way too long.
Way too long.
And here it is now. Like, what? I could have done that
Doesn't
twice.
Matter.
I could have been a doctor twice over. Two different doctors. Two different. I could have, whatever. Like, you know, I mean, I could have been a doctor and then gone back and then been a lawyer and a whatever. But,
well, it doesn't matter because you did it.
Yeah, I guess
so. So everybody out there that like, oh gosh, maybe I'm like, I've exhausted it. My parents are mad at me. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to get my degree.
No.
I mean, don't get your degree in PE or some of that. Just leave. Or whatever. Yeah, what's the other one? Maybe communications.
You know what
don't
I heard,
get
though?
Into communications.
You know what I heard, though? Just get your – what I found out, which I should have taken this advice before, it doesn't matter what you get your degree in as long as you have one.
Okay.
Because I was always
not in PE.
Oh my gosh, I really want to do something really great. I want to be, I don't want to just get a degree in anything because that's just like, what?
No, nobody cares about that.
Nobody gives a shit about it.
No, but those other degrees, though.
Yeah, I even found out even with PE, as long as you still have a degree.
Well, you are almost like, there's only one person who has a larger degree, and that would be 98 degrees.
You know what? Only you and I know 98 degrees, and probably every
you, me, and Nick Lachey know that he's true.
And Jessica Simpson.
That's right.
Goodness. You know what I think, though? I think
you know what I think is I'm so happy here.
I know, me too. It's like I
No, well, hold on.
I haven't been able to get out.
Me too. Don't
I haven't been able to get out. I have not been able to get out.
Don't you utter me too words.
I know. That's another thing I was just thinking about.
You have not been able to get out, Miss May?
No, you're lucky. I kept thinking to myself, gosh,
no,
I wish.
No, I'm not lucky. The world is lucky.
Yeah, you're lucky because you don't have kids and you're single and you get to live the good life.
Not about the good life.
It's called freedom. Freedom.
Is it?
Yeah. And you have it.
Well, I've been free.
Yeah, and you're loving life a bit.
I actually am.
You have no one to answer to.
No, I've fallen in love many times.
Yeah, I'm like, fucking Steven over there.
I fall in love and then I don't.
Yeah, we both know falling in love only lasts 2 weeks.
Hey,
it only lasts two weeks. I know, 2 weeks are great. I remember that too. When I was younger and single and no kids, it was awesome.
Yeah, but you know what? You chose that.
Chose or just fell into it. Whatever. It doesn't even matter. I mean, yeah, I love my kids, but I just think like, wow, everybody's envious of somebody that... We're all envious of you.
Well, I'm envious of that you have kids because honestly, at least you did something with your life. Because if I were to die tomorrow, all I would have would be this podcast.
Yeah, that's what's wrong with that. I mean,
to carry on the tradition. To carry on the tradition of Moraga, it'd only be me... And some crazy lesbian up north. Who's not even a Moraga.
Speaking of.
But oh, well, I just wanted to
you know,
be
you were
brown.
Telling me.
Yeah, I do have a crazy lesbian cousin.
You know, it's crazy because you told me about her. And I kid you not, in one of my books for class at school, her name popped up. Moraga popped up in the book. And I thought, oh my gosh. Wow, she's really that well known. And she even has a little accent mark. Above the, I don't know, the I or the E. Like, yeah. I'm like, wow, what is it, like, French?
Well, that's fake, too.
Is that French? Is that, like, a French?
It's fake, like, she
a
is.
A French-Canadian?
She is a French-Canadian. She actually is. Her last name is Lawrence.
She?
Her last name is Lawrence.
That must be a little tick above the I or the E.
Yeah, her dad's still alive, and he's probably ashamed.
But she's not even a Moraga, though.
She's not a Moraga. To everybody out there, she's not a Moraga.
And she teaches at Stanford, ever.
Stanford.
How does she get in my textbook? Wow.
She got your textbook because... The indigenous people.
Is she a doctor? Does she have people call her doctor? Does she have a PhD?
No.
Because, I mean, I could see her, like, no? They don't call her Dr. Moraga?
No, that would be an insult to the women of color.
What would be her real last name? Like her
Lawrence.
Lawrence.
Yeah, Lawrence. That's her real last name.
Yeah, Professor Lawrence.
Yeah, and to everybody out there, yeah, she's
not for real. She's in her textbooks.
I mean, I'm nothing against her. I don't care. She's a nice person, but don't try to make money off my last name because that ain't your last name, you dummy.
But I just wanted to be brown.
You know, I was speaking of last names.
Yes.
I wanted to change. What if you like my last name isn't really my last name, but it's not really my biological. It's not even a. Hmm? It's an adopted last name. It's my grandfather's.
Is it Carlos's name?
My grandfather's. Santa. It's a stepfather last name. It's my grandfather's stepfather, and I wanted to change it back.
To
Collins. That would have been the real name.
Ooh, like the drink?
Yeah, it would have been Tom Collins, Michael Collins, like the yeah it would have been cool. And Megan Collins, that just sounds
Megan Collins.
It just sounds
that's
cool.
Like a book.
Collins, like that's like a professional
like
name.
It is actually.
You know what I mean?
It's like a murder mystery.
Yeah, like anybody with Collins.
Like you could write a book and like every book would sell.
Anybody with any Irish name, like last name.
Megan O'Collins. Like,
Megan Collins, that's just
That doesn't sound as good. Megan O'Leary. That doesn't sound as good.
Add the O to it. Collins. Megan.
Yeah, Megan Collins sounds dope. Yeah.
Right?
I think you should go by that. Yeah, Polish. I don't know what. I don't. According to
Carl. I heard the stepfather was an asshole, too. So.
Well, pick your asshole.
I'll pick the Collins. I'll pick the one with a better last name.
And the one that sounds good. It kind of rolls right? Yeah, wait. Megan Collins sounds good.
That sounds. Yeah. That
sounds good.
Right?
Yeah.
So.
What if you married Colin?
Colin Collins.
He would take your name. Okay, that'd be hilarious.
I don't even
Colleen. Colleen.
You know what's weird? I think I've solved the mystery because I have a professor that has a last name that just seemed like it was two last names. And what I found out, I think this is the mystery solved, is that he took his wife's last name and his last name, put it together like as if you know how a woman would take like hyphenated?
Oh,
so
God.
So did he. And I was like,
what?
Yes.
He and hyphenated?
He just put it as one. He slammed it together. And I thought, oh my gosh, that's so crazy. Because I was like, I don't get this. Because I've had both of them, both the husband and wife, as two separate, like my professors.
Yeah, of course.
And I was like, wait a second, why does her name, like, and then.
Well, he's the teacher, he should know.
And I realized they both combined. He did it, like, oh if his God. Wife did it, he did it too.
So, like, if I. Oh my God!
I don't want to give away their last names, but it would be like
we never want
if
to
you
that.
Married somebody, give a last name like.
Shit.
Let's say you married a Gonzalez.
Okay, pounds, pounds.
Okay,
pounds.
So it was
be
like
more pounds.
It would be like you took the last name Moraga Pounds.
Yeah, more pounds.
Moraga Pounds.
Oh, Moraga Pounds.
Moraga Pounds.
Pounds that ass. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Who Cares podcast. It is COVID season. It is in the making. We can't imagine what you're going through. I'm sure that some people have died in your family. Maybe if you live on the East Coast, I apologize. But you know what? Over here, knock on wood, nobody's got it.
Yeah. Oh.
On wood right here.
So we, what you mean? Do we know of any, I mean.
I don't know.
I don't even know. We don't know anything really. But
yeah,
don't.
And this is, what's today's date? May the 15th or something. No, May.
All I know is that the news stations, the local news that you listen to, if you're in the U.S.
Yes.
You cannot trust them because they're owned by powerful.
Conglomerates.
Exactly.
We're not owned by nobody.
Yes.
Yeah. We're owned by.
So we don't really know what's.
We're owned
really
by. Around. We're owned by good-looking people.
All we know is that we don't know anybody personally that has gotten it.
No, I don't.
And we know. I mean, you know a lot more. You know a lot.
I lay with a lot of people.
I know. I'm talking six. I'm talking 6 degrees of separation. I don't even know a person like from the sixth degree that knows anybody that's gotten it.
I wear a mask and that's it.
Me too. And I feel like because I've been to other cities where they're not wearing masks.
It's
and I'm
chafing
like,
my ear.
Am I the only fucking person where like?
Yeah. Oh, you've been to other cities, really?
Yeah, like Orange County, Anaheim.
No, we all wear masks.
Anaheim, they don't give a shit.
No.
Oh yeah, I went into a restaurant. They didn't care. I am serious. I went to Anaheim, close to Disneyland, and they do not give a fuck. I was like, I look like an idiot wearing a mask.
No way.
I'm so serious.
This big league.
Yes.
I know you suck.
I swear to you, and I felt like the outside because I was wearing a mask there.
No way, because I feel like everybody in Orange County.
And I don't live in Orange County. I'm from LA County, South Montebello, South
Florida. Okay, I dabble around now.
And well, this part of Anaheim, nobody gives a shit.
Well, nobody gives a shit. And that's what everybody's starting to understand.
Do they not give a shit? Or do they really know what's going on?
That's what I'm saying.
An inside scoop.
Anaheim? Really? Well, leave it to Anaheim, huh? To really know the fuck. To really know the situation. No, but let's be honest about this. To everybody out there, maybe they don't understand. Or maybe they're definitely
scared.
Absolutely, because COVID is real.
Yeah, yeah.
Some people are dying according to the...
Yeah,
the,
according to...
When I get on my old Google machine, I get on the old Yahoo.
Google's also owned by, you know...
Yeah, and I see people dying, these people on the front lines, and I understand that...
Well, we don't really see people dying, we're seeing the numbers.
Doing little stories.
I have not actually seen a life.
Well, every story that they say about... No, I've never seen the dead. But every story that they show, the person is absolutely obese, or they're 80,000 years old.
But they're talking to them, though. They're not showing them.
No, they show a picture. But they're obese.
They show them dead, though?
They're obese? Oh, shit. You're saying that maybe...
I want to see actual proof.
You want to see dead people?
Like, in Mexico, they show the real shit. Like, if somebody dies on the street, they'll show that dead body on the street. Let me see who you're talking about that has died from COVID. Give me a glimpse.
Yeah, what does it look
like? You can blur out their face, but let me see them, like, their dead body on, like, in the slab. Like,
you think they die a different way?
I don't even know if they're dead. Who knows? We don't even know if they're dead.
Maybe they didn't die from COVID.
Maybe they're not even dead.
Maybe you said something earlier that you were talking to me about how maybe COVID... they're not really dying from COVID.
Well, not only that, but also, okay, people have like a weak immune system, maybe.
Right.
Okay, so that's, okay.
You're a nurse.
And people can die from the regular flu from if they have a weak immune system.
Right.
But I'm talking about, do we know that anybody, we're not seeing dead bodies. I mean, I did really recently see like a special on Vice in Italy. Okay. That was Italy. I'm talking about in the U.S.
Okay.
If this many people died, can you at least give me a glimpse of... can I see in the hospital?
Of our fate?
And I see in the cold room where they pull out the slabs of
a young, healthy motherfucker.
Can I just see? You can blur out their face. Can I just see? Then again, I wouldn't even know if that was from COVID. You're right.
We wouldn't because they what did you say? Everybody gets money.
Have you seen Wag the Dog, the movie? And it's about basically the government's conspiracy to like get everybody to believe one thing by putting it out in the news. If you watch that movie, it's exactly what's happening right now. Except they're claiming this is COVID-19 instead of... whatever the situation was in the movie.
Well, the reason why it's called COVID-19 is because there was 18 different strands of COVID before this one. Do you know that?
Yeah, called the flu. I mean, you know, if we're going to dig out numbers, dig out the numbers on the flu, and it's the same thing. You could die more... Shit. More people could probably die if you have a rat.
What?
The plague. The rats, how the rats cause...
Oh, you know about the rats,
though. And that was just fucking rats, and we...
Yeah. You know about the rats? They are now scrambling because all the food is not there for them to consume. So now these are some cannibalistic rats that we have, and they're eating themselves because they don't know what to do because the food isn't out there for everybody.
So I hope that solves the rat problem.
That's what I'm saying. Are we talking about humans or are we talking about rats?
No, I'm talking about rats because I have a rat problem at where I live.
I've had some rat problems too, those motherfucking people talking shit.
But we don't know anything really. I just think like it's hard to trust anybody. It's hard to trust the news. It's hard to
because really like it's either they hate Donald Trump or they love him. Either one, right?
And then
they talk about some COVID stuff and then that's it. Do you know the amount of secrecy? Do you know the amount of lies that are happening within the world? The espionage that's going on.
Of course, there is a deep state. I don't even like. I'm not even. I'm neutral.
Oh, I'm saying even, globally, like that's crazy.
There's people like I don't want to press like our government is pretty fucking crazy. Like we think that like the Middle East and all these other countries.
Yeah. I think there's just boogeyman.
Our government is fucking scary, and if you mess with them.
Yeah, like, well, let's talk about it more on the cast.
No, I mean, I don't want to be, like, I don't want to, like, people should wake up, though, to the fact that the news isn't, like, you can't count on the news yet.
What is the news?
And I'm not even trying to,
because if you want to call the news, that's ridiculous. It's agenda, death,
yes. And I find it really weird that usually the government doesn't want us to panic or, like, you want to keep people from panicking in a case of emergency,
course.
Right?
And that's the reason why they've given us $1 trillion.
This one,
$3 trillion.
This is different. All the news stations are constantly putting out how the death toll rises and how.
Right.
And I find that really suspicious because why are you putting people in a panic?
Right.
I wonder what's really going on behind the scenes.
Sells.
Because like, why the fuck is?
Why
this?
Don't they show like the people that survived it?
There's been crazy other shit. Like even when we had the SARS, like the other flu. I mean,
SARS?
The SARS, and then the other one. Well,
that was Canada.
The flu. No, even it's never been this wide.
Right.
Like coverage wise, it's been crazy.
Well, because globally, it's
yeah. But
taken out
I'm sure
the
we've
world.
Had we've taken out. I mean, shit. The U.S. government is responsible for killing hundreds of thousands
Jesus.
Of people in third world countries. Like we're exploiters. We love to exploit people for the resources. But we don't care. We don't talk about that on the news.
Right. More but people
this,
probably died.
This fucking flu.
Yes.
Is where it's dominating every fucking news station.
Everywhere. But it's not just us. It's Argentina.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, but really.
George, my mechanic, he said that he talked to people in South America. And what they're doing is they have with their IDs, different than us, odd numbers are able to go to the store one day, even numbers another day.
Oh, really?
Right? That's not a bad idea, though, right?
I hate waiting out. No.
Who knew that South America is the leading thinker?
Who knew that China, the one where this whole thing originated,
China
has got it together?
Yeah, Shanghai
Disney
just
opened. They're opening up their shit now. Everything's
Shanghai Disney just opened.
Gee, whatever, that makes you kind of wonder, like, whoa, what happened there? Did they start this thing and let it spread?
Well, they've been around for 3,000 years. I think they know what the fuck they're doing.
Yeah, they had a better... Yeah, I mean, the fact is that...
They've been around 3,000 years and we're
this
just...
This is like a biological war. This is an example of biological warfare and how it got out of control and how the U.S. wasn't prepared.
So you're telling me... You're right, exactly. Nobody was. And that's what's fascinating about this.
Yeah.
They got us with our pants down.
Yeah. It's like the rats before, you know, in the plague of the...
But I am happy for society. That they,
really?
they got it
you
together.
Don't have kids.
They got it together fast. And everybody got together.
Not as fast as China. They already had serums.
But we're dealing with China. Chinese people are used to listening to the government. They just go, I know China. I listen to government.
Okay? I don't think
we're like, oh, we're free. We just want to do whatever we want to. But we all listen. All of a sudden, boom, mask, boom. Fucking Panda Express, you can't even get to the buffet anymore.
You know, it's funny because, like, we criticize other countries for having communism and mm-hmm. really, this is like an...
They listen to their government.
We supposedly have a democracy, but really, it's funny. All you gotta do is put shit out in the news and everybody's fucking following orders.
Following orders, you motherfuckers.
Is that almost like... It's almost like a...
You should be running around with no pants on.
A democracy that...
When you want it.
It's like a... Yeah, I mean, it's ridiculous. We're all... I mean...
No, but you know what? And we'll get to this. We're going to be doing the last four episodes here. Mm-hmm. We started this a couple episodes before. It's called the Huntington Beach Unity Community Group. And it is fascinating to listen to entitled people talk about the trials and tribulations and the horrors of living here in Huntington Beach.
Give me an example of what, like a sneak preview of like one of the examples of
sneak
the
preview. Okay.
Tribulation that they have to go through.
Well, it all, like my business partner here, Ant, He said, it all starts off with, well, I just saw this. Can you believe this?
Yeah.
You won't believe what this is. So they're all ratting each other out.
Yeah.
Like, it's just a Winnebago. Or it's just a little thing. Like, maybe the guy's homeless, maybe he's not.
Yeah.
But why take a picture? You're going to take time out of your day. Can you believe what this person did?
I know. Right.
Is that crazy?
Or you know, there's another crazy thing.
What?
How about when we say, "Oh, when everybody like retweets something like to support like a social activism," but really, that shit doesn't do. Okay, yeah, I like this. I check this off. I'm passing it on to somebody else by sharing this. But how are you actually solving fucking anything?
Well, let me just tell you, and I don't want to throw anybody under the bus, but
like,
I will.
Yeah,
I will. I saw recently that one of my cousins ran for the black man that.
That's great. What did it do for that person?
That's what I'm saying.
Exactly. That person's still dead or in a ditch or dying or...
Maybe it raised some money for
someone. Did it? Do you
think
so?
I don't know.
Did it really? Probably not.
But they ran. And then that's fine if you want to run.
Just donate fucking money.
No, but that's fine if you want to run. But do you have to take a picture of you running for the black man?
Oh,
running?
It's one of those.
You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. Like, run. Yeah. Donate money. Whatever you want to.
Don't tell about your whole thing.
What do we care?
Yeah. If good you did it, great. Let that money go through to them.
Nah, they won't.
That's another thing. Hey, everybody, can you donate your money so all I have to do is run and I don't have to donate my money to help this cause?
Oh.
Donate your fucking money. You know?
Yeah, no shit.
I'm broke all the time, but I still get my last dollar to help somebody.
Well,
like,
you're not going
to
run.
I ain't going to run. Fuck that. I wouldn't. But
hold on. One second.
What does that do? Yeah, it raises awareness, but awareness is not
the awareness is already there, though.
Awareness doesn't help.
But let me just tell you. This plight of this, and it's a horrible situation for the black dude that was running and he got gunned down by some idiot hicks, right?
Oh, can you imagine though?
I know.
Oh, you're gonna run for me?
I know, but real quick.
I'm dead, you're gonna run?
I know, but whatever. It's already got massive amounts of attention. The whole world is already shining its light on.
But attention doesn't do shit.
Okay, but fine. What about there's other people that probably were gunned down too?
Fuck yeah.
In cold blood.
If I was going
to
bring
why don't we run for them to bring attention to them?
Why don't we just donate a dollar? If everybody just donated $1,
to what?
Just $1.
To who?
To every
what's
person.
Play.net?
Okay, that too, yeah. And we'll donate that money to...
We'll donate that money to...
Any...
No. We will donate... Listen, you guys go to what's play.net, sign up for the newsletter. You tell me what we should donate. You donate something. Yeah. You tell us what we need to donate it to, and we will donate it. And the majority wins.
Victims of homicide, other third world countries.
Victims, not COVID. We're not going to do that shit.
Yeah. I mean,
I'm over that shit.
Yeah, it's flu. People, yeah. I mean, flu, yeah, flu sucks.
Hey, have you ever thought about being a podcaster like myself? Well, you can't be like me, but I want you to be that innovative, that wonderful, spectacular voice that the world needs. But you got to come to the What's the Play family, because we moved over here to Anchor. We left Spreaker behind and we moved over here to Anchor.fm, because Anchor is your one-stop shop for recording, hosting, and distributing your podcast. Best of all, it's 100% free and it's ridiculously easy to use. And now Anchor can match you with great sponsors too, like myself, so you can get paid to podcast. So remember, go to anchor.fm/start and join me and the What's to Play family. You know how to get a hold of me. And make sure you do it today, because I can't wait to hear your podcast.
And you know
And it kills. But
it does.
We already know that.
So, you know, stubbing your toe, also 30,000 people a year.
Okay, see? But you know what? People that just are walking down the street, they get shot in the head by some bullet.
Wait, hold on.
No, I'm just saying, people that,
people do
get
not
in the crossfire. I'm just talking about people that get murdered.
Yeah.
I mean, that's fucked up.
100%.
How about that shit?
I would say at least 10,000.
They probably were walking to their job.
I would say at least 10 to 20,000 people.
I mean, it's awful.
Right. And we're like at, 60,000 COVID?
I mean, there's homicides every day.
80,000.
Shit, you go to Chicago, and that's probably
Yeah, we were at Chicago. Remember, they wouldn't even take... The Uber drivers wouldn't even take us.
Southside,
that's another thing. Yeah. Okay, so Uber... You know, everybody used to think Uber is the golden child of Silicon Valley. Mm-hmm. And in fact, when I was pitching our application and all this stuff, everybody's like, well, what are you? Are you the Uber of this? It was always, are you the Uber? And every other pitch artist were like, they'd always say this, we're going to be the Uber of this, kind of monetizing and streamlining every kind of information that whatever you're pitching, it's going to be streamlined just like Uber does, where nobody's really involved and you can't get anybody on the phone.
I
hate Postmates that shit. Or an Uber or right?
Customer service is gone.
It's gone, right?
Yeah.
Well, we're going to get back.
Yeah.
But so everybody, and guess what? Uber's been losing, I want to say 2 million a week.
Yeah, because people, there's probably a lot of drivers aren't even going to do this shit. They're like,
not only are they not driving, but would you get in a car knowing that 10 people before you might have COVID? So you don't want to send that.
You want to have your car being occupied by people that...
Well, let me just tell you. Yeah, all the girls that I've met through Tinder or Plenty of Fish, mm-hmm. whatever, I say, I'm going to send you a lift. I will send you a lift. And they said, I'm scared. And I go, well, last week you weren't. So what changed this week?
I mean, what?
Right. So it must be that they're worried about sitting in the back seat, COVID.
That's crazy, because I think more people are at risk of
right getting herpes.
Yeah, from a random person. I mean, you have more risk.
I know. I'm at risk. I am at the front lines every day.
I know you are. That's what I think. You are at the front lines.
COVID.
That's one of the things.
COVID.
You may
but
not
gonorrhea?
Have kids, but that just puts you more at risk, because when you don't have kids and you're single, you can do whatever you want.
I've lived
you
this
could,
long.
You're
I've lived
risk.
This long without a disease that has lasted with me forever. So
I know.
So you whatever. Yep. I say, roll the dice.
Yep. Yeah, see? It's more, it's that bravery. It's bravery right there, you know? I wish
Snake
I had
eyes.
The bravery.
The bravery. Remember that band?
You know. Oh, they're gone now, huh?
What is that?
And that's another thing, too. This COVID-19 is just destroyed cool...
Cool people?
Cool bands.
They
die? I don't know, but they're it's just you don't hear about them anymore.
You know what? But listen, has anybody really got that upset because nobody knows about what fucking Scarlett Johansson is doing? Or somebody from
cares.
Fucking, from some stupid,
can I tell you something?
The Bachelor?
I think celebrities realize this, and that's why they're so desperate to
be sad as fuck.
They're like, oh my gosh, hey everybody, we're in this together. That's another thing. We're in this together.
No, you're
if
not.
I have to hear that shit one more time.
We're in this together.
Are you here? Are you in my house right now?
Yeah.
Are you really? You're
because,
in this together
with me? Because even though you're a celebrity, I wouldn't look at you. Because
I see you
street.
Behind your gated fucking house. That's you know, you got this huge lot, and you could have servants serving you all the time.
I wouldn't say servant. Listen, the person that's in one TV show or something.
Yeah. What I'm just saying that they have.
There's some people that have servants, but I would say it's
people
you.
That. I mean, does it really? Basically, they could have money.
Yeah,
to
the world
just
can move on without
out.
Them.
Yeah, and it's like. I hope that they lose all their money during this.
Wow. You're really going to hope that on all celebrities?
Nah, I don't hope they lose all
Tom
their
Hanks?
Money, but at least 50%.
Do you want Tom Hanks to lose 50% of his money?
Yeah, fuck yeah. He can survive. He still would have way more than I would have.
Well,
you know, now's the time.
But he earned it.
Now's the time.
He earned it.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I guess every celebrity, the one that's, you know, they all have that same story, the backstory.
What's the backstory?
Oh, they had to live out of their car for so many months. And then, you know, whatever.
I did that a little bit, but.
You know, whatever.
I just have this podcast.
Live out of your car with their parent. Like, maybe they were like, it was just them and their mom. Or
their stage mom, like Taylor Swift's mom.
And they just, like, like, worked as a waiter.
I'm surprised Taylor Swift's mom survived COVID because she's an absolutely obese lady.
Is she, like,
she's absolutely obese.
I always thought, like, I didn't think that her parents were still together because I thought, like, her...
They're not.
Her mom,
I don't know.
Well...
I don't know because I used to love her. And then I saw her mom and I'm like, oh, shit. At some point, she will be her mother.
You think so?
Yeah. Like,
what
your
about
mother,
her dad? What
your
about
mother
her dad,
is absolutely
though?
Beautiful. So I look at you.
Oh, thank you.
You will stay the same.
Do you think... What about Taylor's dad, though? Because I know Taylor's dad.
Kobe's dad? Kobe's dad. That's the weirdest thing. Okay, let me ask you about that. Has anybody ever fucking heard from Kobe's parents?
No.
We've talked to Jerry West. We've talked to every player. We've talked to his wife, whatever she was. We've talked to his mistresses. In fact, we were gonna try to get Kate Faber on this podcast. I got her number.
I got her number
when she wanted not to. I got it back in the day. I had it, and my cousin Monica called her, left a horrific message.
That was when Colorado.
Her name's Kate Faber, and we would stop at nothing, people. We will do this for you on the Who Cares Pod. Maybe that's our 50th anniversary. We're going to get her on the phone.
Did you see what she looks like now? Or did you see what she looks like?
I've never seen what she looked like before.
And no?
All I know is she doesn't take anal sex too well.
All I thought was, wow, if that's what he's hooking up with, and he'll hook up
you
with anybody.
You saw a picture?
I remember on the National Fire.
I said she was a little sloppy, right? Sloppy?
Well, we'll have to do that research on the break right
now. We don't
now.
Want to talk bad about it because maybe she's going to be on the cast.
I'm not even saying,
she's going to be on this fucking cast.
I'm just 50. Saying, just a regular person.
Will you be on that cast with us?
Yeah,
on that phone call?
Yo,
Well, no, she's being. We're gonna interview her. I bet you I can get her.
You probably could, but I don't like to
I may have to pull some strings.
I'm
meaning I may have to I may have to do some of the things that you don't want to do. May have to.
You might have to hook up with her and spoon her.
Yeah, and if she's as sloppy as you think you're saying she is.
And that was back in what?
If she was sloppy 10, 15 years ago, good God, imagine what she looks like now. Oh my God.
But you already
she probably
said
is the size of Colorado. She's probably the size of Colorado, the fucking peaks.
But you're already committed.
It takes to get to get us to the cast here, to get what you need.
You know what? Can we make that a contest?
All up in that ass.
When you say that, I think we should do what would Steven do?
That's a good question.
You know?
Yeah, what would Steven do?
Yeah. Let's put it out there. What would you do? To get,
you know, it's funny you said that. What you said, what would I do to what?
Yeah, what would Steven do to get more listeners? More,
Well, I can is put a barometer on this, right? So, I used to manage an exceptional talent, Leilu. She was an amazing girl, And I took her to her first musical, right? At the Cerritos Performing Arts Center, Kaepernick Center, right?
Yeah.
And the man that runs it, I thought he was
but
an amazing
still didn't
guy.
Do much.
Hold on 1 second. So, the man that runs it.
Yeah.
I was, in her ear, do you see what they're doing? Blah, blah, blah. Then we go out. I was like, let me introduce you to this man. I'm not going to say any names. Let me introduce you to him. And he goes on and on. I'm like, oh my God, you are so handsome. It's great to see you. And basically shoves a 15 and a half year old girl out of the way and comes over to this handsome gentleman, which I'm not upset about that.
Yeah.
I understand.
Yeah.
But he's I'm like, well, look, I just want to talk to you. Like, maybe there's a role for her. Something new. Oh, yeah. Why don't we go to Laguna, where I live, and we can have dinner? And listen, I was telling Aunt that I'm her manager. So I will do whatever it fucking takes to get her in this motherfucking, for have her shine, right?
Yeah.
However, there's got to be a limit. I definitely will have dinner.
Is there?
Well,
that's
depends on what. Top beds about what kind of money we're talking about.
I mean, I'm sure a lot of people that are celebrities now that make millions of dollars, they had to do something.
Kesha?
Something.
Kesha?
That was beyond,
Right.
It's going to be more than dinner. It's going to have to be something, it's like that question, what would you do for $1 million?
You're saying it's lava cake?
It's something that you thought maybe you'd probably never do.
Mm.
Maybe what your parents taught you never.
Right.
Don't let anybody
dirty.
Do this to you.
Well, it depends on what, I wanted to make Leilu a star.
I've thought about this too, yeah.
I don't know, because when I got home, I had to really process that, because I know he kept emailing me and stuff, and I had to process that. And fortunately or unfortunately, so we didn't have to like go that route.
Let's just put it this way: your mind can block things out. Your mind is, you know, your mind has been built to block.
I can see that.
Horrible stuff out. So,
right.
You know, 10 years from now, you would forget about it.
Yeah, you know, like my whole life has pretty much been uneasy. No, my whole life has been fucking amazing, except for like around the time like I met you.
I know.
No, when I met you, it was still fantastic until I met like this one girlfriend, and then I blocked it out pretty much since then.
You know, it's crazy. Your mind is pretty that's what everybody's built.
And you know who you are.
You know, but seriously, I mean,
I'm just kidding. Maybe you were a bright light in a dark tunnel.
But back to the game. Oh, thank you so much. No, but you're skating around this question of the game of what would Steven do?
Like, I don't know.
We're gonna put it out there.
What do you think I would do?
That's what people should do. Like, oh, I want you to do this for and I'll
for what? What are we talking?
Okay, I'll bring my friends in and we'll listen to.
Well, hold on, for Leilu, like I thought that this girl, and I still do. She's listening out there. Yeah. I still think, and she still is actually under contract, but I still think that she by far is the most talented person I have ever seen. She's incomparable. Yeah. So and I felt that I owed it to her. So if you're talking about leverage, then there would be different stuff that I would have done to get her to be
But this is your seen. Project. This is your project.
To get her to be seen. So what are you asking then?
I'm saying like,
just for shits and giggles?
No. If people, if you could bring in the more listeners like you.
Oh, more listeners
and subscribers. More subscribers to the cast.
What are the subscribers paying?
How do you have it set up? I don't know.
Well, listen, you go to patreon.com and you go to What's the Play Patreon and you can subscribe because Miss Meg Lee, she needs the money. And so do I.
But there's a cool little fun.
Have we not been giving you all that cast up in your ass?
It's also a cool fun game. It's like a truth or dare.
Yeah, but have we not given them cast up their ass?
I mean, I think so. I mean, you know, legitimate, like valid, like real answers. We're not like fake news. Or,
Absolutely not.
I hate to say that because I feel like I'm quoting Donald Trump. I'm just saying. Really?
You have been fantastic. Almost
we've been real.
We're at 47 episodes.
We've been real.
You have been fantastic through 42 of them.
Thank you. Well, I think
because you've only been on.
We've been real. We tell the truth. We're not trying to, you know what I mean?
That's right.
Like shove bullshit up your ass.
That's right.
I'm also saying that it would be like a truth or dare to you.
Mm-hmm.
We get.
Oh my god! The wildest. You did not just say that right now.
It's like okay, I dare you, if you know Steven, to do this, and will you do it? And if you do, you get subscribers, more subscribers. I mean, I really want to play this game, too.
Patreon.com. Patreon.com/whatstoplay. Or you can go to twitch.tv.
Patreon.
You know Patreon. patreon.com/whatstoplay.
Cool.
Or you can go to twitch.tv/whatstoplaygames. Right. The other night.
And it's fun.
Is that weird that you just said that?
I know.
And I was like, wow. So immature, but so awesome.
I know.
Get naked. Truth or dare?
Wow. And did you get to ask? Did you ask to ask her the same question?
And
did she do it? The truth or dare?
Everything.
Did you dare? Or did you?
Yeah, it was so hot.
Did you ask a truth or did you ask like
how
a dare?
How do they know that it's so hot to play those games?
I know it's fun. It's because it's like
it's fun, huh? Truth or dare is fun, everybody.
Because it's like
Megan and I are actually naked. We're figuring. I'm figuring her, and she's jerking me off right now.
I'm asking him to go over to the neighbor's house right now.
We would never do that. We're brother and sisters.
Yes.
That would be weird. Hot, but weird.
And we are like brother and sister because I'm daring you to go over to your neighbor's house.
Oh, God. They're Mexican. I'm half Mexican, everybody. Stop it. What do you want me to do? Quinceañera?
Go over there and make out with the daughter.
Oh, God. She's at least 350 pounds.
Go over there.
All right.
Yeah.
If I hear it come out, I'll be like, hey, mija.
Or you could even just kiss her on the lip. You don't have to do tongue, but you just like
I'll give her
one
some
hard
tamarindo.
Kiss. One hard kiss on
I'll
the
give
mouth.
Her some tamarindo.
One hard kiss on the mouth.
I'll give her a kiss on the mouth.
Or basically the first person that comes out of there.
No, they got herpes. I'm trying to protect myself from this COVID shit.
Oh, that would be a good dare.
What's interesting though is like you know, I live in a gated community. Uh-huh. And but I do have neighbors. As Megan alluded to.
Yes. Everybody
has neighbors. Not one of them is working. So I don't know why any fucking The landlord is talking to me about nothing.
I'm just wondering, yeah, how does anybody keep
their... How does anybody have any fucking...
You know, as a place to live?
Yeah.
I know.
Well, they got that stimulus check. Have you got your stimulus?
Yeah, I did. I already fucking...
Whoa, you
came
got
and
one?
Went. Came and went.
You got one?
Yeah, I did, and I spent it on my
kids. You got one?
Yeah.
You spent it on your kids? Wait, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa, let's give it a let.
No, actually, and I had to pay my mom back, too. Oh, it is. How do I always get the dirty...
Dirty what?
The
dirt?
This.
These.
That's...
Oh, nice.
I always walk into that one right there.
These.
Right there, see? Yeah,
right by your crotch.
Right? Fuck.
How did you get that?
Because...
That's a whole trail.
And you charcoaled on my...
Charcoal.
This thing right here, so...
Yeah, well, just call us a fucking barbecue.
But anyways,
Meg Lee.
So the game, Truth or Dare.
Right.
And that's my dare for you.
Well, this, and I don't want to say this, so I don't want to give out exactly what we're going to be doing with the new episodes.
I know.
I'm very enunciating stuff right now.
You're good.
However, I don't want to say that it's going to be live, but it just might be.
Oh, wow. Really? You're going to live?
That's... What do you mean? I'm going to. You're going to be a gonna part of two.
Oh, we're going to do it live?
So I think we got to ask the people. For the next episode, what do you think it should be called? Should it be called an Evening with Stifting?
Or a Truth or Dare? A Night of Truth or Dare?
Truth, I mean.
You could choose Truth or you could choose Dare.
Truth or Dare.
You know you
have
the choice. You
Truth or Dare with Stephen Moraga.
Sometimes I wonder like, oh, because...
Yeah.
Because if Truth...
Trust me, I know. It just happened the other night.
Did you go for Truth or Dare?
I went for both. When it
fucking, you can go... You went for both. No.
When it fed the fancy.
Yeah. But when somebody asked you when it was your turn...
It depends on what... At that moment, what I wanted.
I would have gone for Truth. I would go for Truth because you don't know what the fuck the dare is going to be. That's like, the dare could be like, oh.
I mean, who cares at that moment? You're already infatuated with the person.
Yeah, but like the dare could be, they might
you
even
eat
just,
that pussy, you like, can eat the butt.
Yeah, but I'm just saying like, okay.
Oh, you could like slap them with a penis.
Or you could also say, what if they bring it to an outside party? Like I just...
Not if they're house sitting.
Go to the... I mean, that's...
Cameras.
That's true, I mean...
It has to be in the one room.
But what if they really...
You're stuck to the room.
You know?
You're stuck to the room. How about that? Now it's on.
Well, then the dare's not going to be that much of a dare.
Yeah, yeah,
that dare's not going to be much of a dare. What the whole point of dare is like, you got to do something really crazy.
Well, there's crazy things within a human body that you can do.
But you're already going to have sex with that person anyway, so what...
Maybe not. You don't know.
Okay.
Maybe it's just a lead-up.
I would say, like, the dare would be like, go have sex with somebody that you're not going to have, like, you know...
Go have sex with someone you're not
going to have sex with? Like, go have sex with that.
Like the one you're telling
me about. Go have sex with the 80-year-old.
The large Mexican?
No, that's
like the large Mexican girl next door?
Go have sex,
you just told me to go have sex with the large Mexican girl next door.
I said with a neighbor.
Yeah, with neighbor means means large Mexican girl next door. She's large.
Okay.
She's sweet, though.
Yeah?
Not really. She didn't used to like me, but now she
does. Yeah, I remember she was like, is that the one that revved the car?
I don't know. Did she really? She revved the car?
The rev the car. Remember, like,
the Reverend
like,
Horton Heat?
Rev the engine.
Reverend Jesse Jackson? Like, the Reverend Al Sharpton? Who the fuck are you talking about?
Remember, like, the car was like, brr, like, when, like she would take off? Probably. Like, it was, like, really loud, like, made it, like,
I'm sure.
Like, you know?
Yeah, they always want to. They always want to do stuff with their cars.
But I want
to. Hose on them?
But yeah, so that's what I would say. You would have to, you know,
I will fuck that fucking fat shit.
On a dare. So on a dare,
You give me...
Can I see?
What, do I get a...
Every dare that you can go through
I
with?
Get a gift certificate to Alberto's?
No, you get one to Gonzalez.
Do I get a quinceanera?
To Gonzalez Northgate.
Oh, shit. I love that fucking place.
I know.
Holy shit. No, you
Nobody
know what?
Nobody serves hot food anymore, 100%.
What you just said right now, I want to give a big shout out to
he went to St. Paul
Northgate Market.
The Sun, it was
The Sun.
They were just starting that market, like the he's like my brother's age.
Yeah.
His parents were starting
Gonzalez?
That market.
They're the Gonzalez's.
Yes.
No, but I want to give a lot of love to Northgate Market.
Yeah, but they could reduce the prices though. That's all I gotta say.
Well, those
doesn't cost that fucking much for a Mexican plate. When they had their hot stuff, like, you know.
Okay, let me just tell you why I want to give love to
them. Tell me.
It's Mother's Day.
Okay, what did you do?
And I go to see my mama.
Uh-huh.
And the day before, I happened to drive by a Northgate Market over here in our area, in Huntington Beach, whatever.
Yeah.
It's like in Garden
Grove. They have one out here, too?
It's a Garden Grove or some shit.
They have one everywhere.
And Garden Grove.
Just started.
It's not really a real place. But, so Garden Grove. Mm-hmm. And they had these bouquets of flowers that you just drive up if you wanted to and pay it. And I thought, well, you know what? That'd be a great thing. But you know what? I'm thinking that, like, oh, with the flowers and the heat, I'm not going to go home right away. I don't want these flowers to wilt. It's a day before Mother's Day. But that's an amazing thing, right? Mm-hmm. So then the next day, I'm like, oh, shit. Now I'm at my parents' house. And once my mom jumped in the shower, I ran out the door. I'm like, I'm just going to go to Vons, get her some fucking bouquet and shit, whatever, card, whatever. How are we going to do it, right?
Yeah.
I go to Vons, and guess what? This little motherfucker behind the counter goes, okay, what you see is what you get. And there's nothing. And I don't know. This is when I realized COVID is real. Because there is no flowers. There is no nothing. And this little fucker is saying, giving me like a little attitude like he is, his last name is Vaughn.
Yeah, yeah. I hate.
So I'm like, all right, fine, Vaughn. I'll see you later. And I said, my parents live in Whittier. So I remembered the day before for Northgate. And I said, you know what? One last shining hope. One last shining star. Yeah. One last glimmer of bright, sunshine.
Yeah.
So I go over there to that Northgate. And yes, there's a line. And you have to COVID it. And because for every large Mexican that leaves, another one goes in.
Okay.
So yes, I had to be in a little line.
Oh, wow.
It's weird like that, right? Because it's COVID time.
I hate waiting in line. It's so stupid.
Before you even get in there, right?
But what difference?
But once I'm in there,
you realize.
I see a young guy and his little assistant wrapping flowers, and in the middle is meat, because everybody's saying there's a meat crisis. No, there ain't no meat crisis at Northgate. There is no meat crisis. There might be a meat crisis at Stater Brothers. There might be a meat crisis at Vaughn's. Ain't no fucking Mexican to even have that. So Northgate supplies more meat, more brisket, more cow's tongue, more cow's balls.
Except nobody has hot stuff anymore.
Okay, well, I don't know. But I see these two people just wrapping up flowers.
Yeah.
Wrapping up flowers.
Cool.
And so I went to the middle. I found that I got this really cool bouquet, and I'm going to show you it. And I matched it to my shirt that I was wearing.
Because everything else
was expensive. Like $25 for everything out the door.
Oh, really?
They wrap it. They put a bow on it. They make it so personalized. The dude fucking put it together like it was like he
probably
really took
went to St.
he
Paul's.
Really took time for it.
Wow.
And they saved my fucking life. Northgate Market, I love you very, very much. Thank you for making my mother smile. Thank you for making her shine. I love Northgate Market.
Wow. That's
They and even the lady that checked me out was so happy.
Really?
She was happy for me.
Really? Because you got there on time to give your mother flowers?
It's like something like that. I don't know.
It
doesn't matter.
You're the only I guess all markets seem to be pretty busy. I can't even say that.
She didn't give a fuck. She said, you know, have a great day.
In English?
Wake up this morning, I'm thinking I can't be still, girl. Too many images running through my mind. Soon as I hit it, I can't get it out of my system. Even my brother, he asked me what you want. I'm on some kind of drug.
Since I met you, you got me changing my schedule. If you ain't know, that's just eventful. And losing this money is dreadful, but believe me, that pussy is special. You wanted me, moms, I might let you. Really, it's so presidential. Keep it on while we fuck, that's cause I'm meant to, yeah. Fuck you twice, we take a nap. Soon as you're awake, get back. Go for three, it takes a knack. I'm taking you to places that you ain't been, girl, face the fact. Meant it, I can't take it back. Whiskey straight, ain't chasing that. I'll taste the cat, yeah. You tell me I own that pearl. Yeah, that's cause I've blown you thorough. You should be my only girl. When I hit it, you feel like you own the world.
I'm on some kind of drug. Yeah. Can't explain. Yeah,
can't explain.
All the ways you give me high.
Give me high.
I'm on some kind of drug. Can't explain. Don't keep me waiting all night. Girl, come through.
Come through.
Them bath water running. Fire be burning in my hotel room. Come through. Champagne be popping.
Since the last time we had sex, honestly, I've been a mess. Well, fiending cause you got the best. Borderline kinda obsessed. And yeah, I'm on some kind of drug. I've been addicted and I cannot find enough.
I call you, I'm trying to fuck. I'm a room 921, come on up. And we can put up the please do not disturb. I got the drink, I got the herb. I'm tweaking now, I must be cured. The only way I rest assured is if I get my fix. I love the way your dress just slips right off your waist, right down your hips. Technique's the best, she knows some tricks. And yeah, I need you now, I need you bad. You and me both been fiending bad. I guess what I really mean is that
I want some kind of yeah.
Can't explain
all the ways you get me high. I'm on some kind of drug. Can't explain. Don't keep me waiting.